Hello students, today we are going to start IGCSE ICT chapter number 1, that is types and components of computer system. In this chapter we have further topics hardware and software, main components of computer system, operating system, types of computer and impact of emerging technologies. But in this video we will discuss only hardware and software. Okay, so what is basically hardware? Physical components of your computer system that are tangible, physically exist, just like motherboard, memory, sound card, printer, projector, monitor. So these all are your hardware devices, physical components. On the other hand, what are software? The programs used for controlling the operation of a computer or for the processing of your electronic data. So the programs which you use for yourself or for the purpose of maintenance purpose of the computer system are the software, and the physical components are hardware. We will discuss in detail. Okay, so basically there are some internal hardware devices and external hardware devices as well. Internal mean that are inside your computer system, okay, that are attached inside your computer system, and external hardware that are present outside your computer system. Just like these are the devices which are internal that are inside your computer system. The first one is the motherboard. Let me show you the picture of the motherboard first. This is the picture of motherboard. This is your internal hardware device that is inside your computer system. Here you can find the different slots for the RAM, sound card, memory, and for place for the CPU also, and the ports are available to connect your external hardware devices as well. So this is the main component, the main printed circuit board of your computer system. It contains electrical components such as CPU and the memory, and the connectors for connecting external hardware devices. Okay, the next internal hardware device is RAM. It's a memory chip used to store data temporarily. It's a volatile memory. What does volatile mean? It means whenever you turn off your computer system, all the data in the RAM will be lost. Okay, there will be no data when you turn on it for the next time. So all the data which is in the RAM will be lost. It is very temporary memory. So data can be written onto it and read from the memory. Basically, it needs for the processing. Suppose I have opened this program right now, so there must be an instructions at the background, so that instructions are temporary at the RAM. Okay, so when I will close this program, that instructions will be removed. When I open any other program, that instruction will be stored automatically in the RAM. So when I turn off my computer, all the instructions from the RAM will be removed. So this is your temporary memory. On the other hand, we have ROM that is used to store data permanently. It is a non-volatile memory. Non-volatile means when you turn off your computer, the data in the ROM will not be lost. It will remain as it is. Okay, data can only be read. RAM was read and write memory, but in the ROM data can only be read. So which type of instructions are stored in the ROM? Let's suppose when we turn on the computer system, when we press the button, so there are some instructions that are loaded, operating system is loaded. So these type of instruction we need frequently and permanently in the same sequence. These type of instructions are stored in the ROM, okay, and these are permanent. We are not going to change it every time. It will be same as it is. This is a picture I have already shown you. Other internal hardware devices, just like video card. This is the expansion card that generates a signal so that video output devices can display text and the graphics. If you are able to view any video on your monitor screen or on the projector, so video card must be present in your computer system. So it will help you to generate the signal so that you can see the video of anything. Sound card, it is also an expansion card that allows the computer to send audio signals to audio devices such as speakers and headphones. So if you are able to hear a sound from your system, it is because of the sound card. These all devices are attached on your motherboard. Sound card, video card. Internal hard disk drive. This is a picture of internal hard disk drive. This is a picture of sound card. Here ports are available to plug in your headphones, speakers, or multiple devices. Internal hard disk device. It's a magnetic material disk onto which programs and data can be stored. We have learned about RAM and ROM to store that data, but that was for the system purpose. If you want to store your own data, your files, your pictures, so you need an internal hard disk drive. External hard disk is also available. We use it for the backup purpose. Okay, so these are the main components and internal hardware devices that are inside your computer system. Okay, now external hardware devices that are outside your computer casing, just like monitors, keyboards, printers, scanners, speakers. Just discuss about the purpose. These are very basic devices. So monitors used to display your output as a soft copy. Okay, keyboards are used to input your text data or numerical data. Printers, these are gives output as a hard copy. Scanners, this is also an input device used to convert your documents to the computer. So any document, any images you want to convert and you want to shift it to the computer, you can use the scanner. Speaker is an output device that is used to gives output as a sound. So these are the external hardware devices that are not inside your but the outside of your computer casing. Okay, now come to the part software. There are two types of software also: application software and the system software. Okay, so what is the purpose of application software? It is designed to carry out certain operations for a particular application. If you want to do any particular task, you need application software for your own purpose. Application software cannot run on its own as it is dependent on the system software. So we need one system software also. So it is application software that dependent on your system software. Okay, just giving one example. Whenever you purchase any computer or laptop, you have an operating system. Operating system is an example of system software. So without operating system, you cannot run any other application. Okay, so application software are dependent on your system software. Let's discuss few of the application softwares we need, we use on our daily routine. First one is a word processing software. Allows composition, editing, formatting, storing and printing of documents. So the works related to your document, just like formal documents or creation of books or letter writing. So for all this purpose, we use word processing software. I'm just giving you one example of word processing software, that is mostly we use Microsoft Word. But please be careful whenever you're doing IGCSE exams. Do not write any example. Just use the general term. General term is word processing software. Do not write any software name. Okay. So you will just use the general term. Next is spreadsheet. Stores data in the cells form. Used to sort data, calculate the numerical values, data analysis, and use mathematical formula. Just giving you one example. We use mostly Microsoft Excel as a spreadsheet. Okay. So here you can store your data in the cells, you can do calculations, you can use mathematical formulas. These type of software known as spreadsheets. Third is database management system. It keeps and manages the records in an organized way. Data can be retrieved based on the specific condition. Mostly we use Microsoft Access as a database. So what is basically a database? You are going to record all the data in an organized way so that you can easily access when you want it. For example, students' data in the school, okay, or the teachers' data, or any employees' data. So database management, you can manage your records in an organized way. And you can retrieve your data based on specific condition. For example, I want to access the names of the students who got marks more than 90. So based on the condition, that is marks should be more than 90. So I can retrieve the data from the database management system. Okay, so example of database management system is Microsoft Access. Then control softwares. Softwares used to supply instructions in order to tell devices such as washing machines, automatic cookers, how to operate. These are basically automatically programmed. So software is automatically programmed and embedded in your device. And you're just like washing machine. So whenever you give it timer, so it will do all the things, all the instructions automatically, and then gives you the output. So these type of software are known as control software. Then measuring softwares used to issue instructions through the sensors. Okay, what are the sensors? Sensors basically take measurement of physical quantities. Computer cannot understand any physical quantity. So to take the measurement, we use sensor, and after that we convert it into the digital form and then send to the computer for processing. Just like temperature sensor is used, it can be used even in the washing machine also. Okay, just to measure, for example, we have set the temperature at 40. So when it comes to the 40, it will tell the control software to do necessary operations. Then apps we use on the smartphones or tabs, applications which we use on the smartphone or tabs are known as apps. Okay. Photo editing softwares that are used to edit your photos, improve, enhance photographs using your computer or any other device, this mobile or smartphones. Resizing, color, brightness adjustment, there are a lot of other features available in all photo editing software. Just giving you one example of the photo editing software, mostly we use Adobe Photoshop. And please, again, I am repeating, do not write the examples. Okay, just giving you the example so that you can understand clearly. So you can use general term only. Next, video editing softwares, the softwares which are used to edit your videos. It take clips and arrange. It can include special visual effects also, sounds, background sounds, or any other visual effects also. You can use in video editing softwares. Then graphics manipulation software used to alter the appearance of the image. Image is basically different from the photo. Photo means, for example, you have taken your own picture and you are going to change that one or edit that one. You can use photo editing software. Images, just like architects used, make maps. So these are the images. To change this, we need graphics manipulation software. Altering size, orientation, color adjustment, etc., and a lot of other features are available in graphics manipulation software. So these are the application softwares. Now come to the system software. We have already discussed that application software used for the users to do any particular task. But on the other hand, system software is the program that controls the hardware by giving step-by-step instruction. So to do maintenance task for the system, we need system software. Okay, to do any task that is particular for the user, we use application software, and for the maintenance and controlling the operations, we need system software. These are the few examples of system softwares: operating system, device driver, compilers, linkers, and utilities. Let's discuss this one by one. First of all, operating system. It is a set of programs that control the system resources. Basically, the user is not concerned how the program is running, how they are working. We are only concerned with the applications. Okay? Let's suppose I am using this software right now, so I am just concerned about this software. How it is going to display, how it is going to do all these things, we are not concerned about these things. Okay? So operating system basically works as an interface or middleman between the hardware and the application software. User is only concerned with the applications. Okay, user is not concerned with the hardware, that how it is going to display, how it is going to give the output as a sound. So operating system, it works as an intermediary between your application softwares as well as the hardware. So operating system is concerned about the hardware, how it will work. And it is also concerned about the application software, so how you are going to display all these things. So user is only concerned with the application. So all these things to control and manage the overall system, we need operating system. It is going to manage all the devices and the work between the application and the hardware devices. Next is compilers. Changes the instruction written in high level language to low level language. Basically, when we write any program, any software, we use high level languages. There are different types, high level and the low level languages, but mostly we use high level language. Why? Because these are English type languages, but computer cannot understand English. So we need to translate it into the form that computer can understand. So compilers are the used to translate high level language into low level language, whole program at once. Okay, it translate whole program as one. Converts the source program to object code. Source program is the program which is written by the programmer, written by us by using the high level language. And after the compilation, what we get, the code which is understandable by the machine, understandable by the computer, and that is known as the object code. Okay. For example, one has written a program by using a C language, C program. So that program is source code. Compiler, after compilation, you get the code, binary code. That program is understandable by the machine. That is now converted in the machine language program, and this is known as the object code. Okay, this object code, basically we give input, this object code will execute and it gives you the output to the user. Okay, device drivers are also examples of the system software. It tells the devices that are connected to the computer how to operate. For example, if you have purchased a new printer to attach to the system, it needs a driver to be installed before using it. Whenever you purchase any new thing, you have a CD or anything, any driver you need to install on this. So what is the purpose of driver? It will tell the device that this is your purpose. On this button, you have to take this action. On this command, you have to take this action. So we need drivers for the hardware devices. But few devices are now recognized by operating system, such as if we insert any pen drive. Pen drive is also a device, USB pen drive. So such as these devices are automatically recognized by the operating system. Okay, you do not need to install the driver now. Okay, linkers is also a type of the system software. It is usually a part of the compiler. Okay, links the code written by the programmer and the other resources in the libraries. Okay, for example, if you are writing a program by using a C language, so there are some things, some features, some functions which you are using from the library of the C programming language. So linker, what it will do, it will usually the part of the compiler, so it will link that code with that library, so that you can easily get the desired result. The functions may work properly. The last one is utilities. It helps the users with everyday tasks, such as if you are doing file maintenance, compressing file, but related to the system. Okay, not your own particular task, it's related to the system. So file maintenance, compressing file, install and uninstall software, formatting tests, burning CDs and DVDs, these all are the examples of utilities. So just giving a short summary, hardware are the physical components. We have studied about internal hardware devices that are inside the computer system and external hardware devices that are outside the computer system. Then software, the programs which we use. We have two types, application software and the system software. Application for the user to do any particular task. System for the maintenance and control purpose. Okay, so we have already discussed about these examples of system software and application software. We will continue the next topic in the next video. Thank you.